Good day to you. You're welcome to RCCG Oklahoma City's Open Heavens Daily Devotional. The Open Heavens Daily Devotional is written by our Father in the Lord, the General Overseer of the Redeemed Christian Church of God, Pastor E.E. Adeboye. And I pray that as you join me today, God will bless you in Jesus' name. Amen. Today, 15th September 2020, we'll be looking at the topic, God is coming to your home, part 3. God is coming to your home, part 3. I'll be taking memory verse from Deuteronomy chapter 23, verse 14, which says, For the Lord thy God walketh in the midst of thy camp, to deliver thee and to give up thy enemies before thee. Therefore shall thy camp be holy, that he see no unclean thing in thee, and turn away from thee. We'll be taking our text from Luke chapter 22, verses 8 to 14, which says, And he sent Peter and John, saying, Go and prepare us the Passover, that we may eat. And they said unto him, Where wilt thou that we prepare? And he said to them, Behold, when ye are entered into the city, there shall a man meet you, bearing a pitcher of water. Follow him into the house where he entereth in. And ye shall say unto the good man of the house, The master saith unto thee, Where is the guest chamber, where I shall eat the Passover with my disciples? And he shall shew you a large upper room, furnished, there make ready. And they went, and found as he had said unto them, and they made ready the Passover. And when the hour was come, he sat down, and the 12 apostles with him. Several years ago, I promised to visit one of my pastors. I told him I would stay only a few minutes, pray, and leave. Since he wanted me to stay a bit longer, he devised a means. He got a very good collection of hymns and started playing just before I arrived. I ended up staying for hours. Do you know God will cut his visit to some home short if the environment is not conducive? Deuteronomy 23:14 says, Therefore shall thy camp be holy, that he see no unclean thing in thee, and turn away from thee. So our Father in the Lord was giving us a scenario, telling us a story about him promising to visit one of his pastors. And he had only planned to spend a few minutes at the home of this pastor. But because the pastor wanted him to stay longer, he did something. Began to play hymns before he arrived, and when the general overseer got there, you know, listening to the hymns, he felt really at home, he enjoyed it, and he stayed for hours. And we are being told that God will stay, whether God will stay or whether God will cut his visit short, is dependent on the environment, is dependent on the environment in which our home is or our life is. It is dependent on the environment. How are we preparing for God's visit? How are we preparing for God's visit? You want God to visit you as a person. How are you preparing? Are you putting your hands into sin? Are you dirty? Are you doing things that God's eyes cannot behold? I mean, if he comes and he meets such a thing, he will go away. We remember from our Bible text or from our memory verse, he clearly stated that the Israelites were to keep their camp clean. No unclean thing should be found in the camp, so that when God comes, he will not turn away, because God is holy and he does not want any unclean thing. So in your life, in your home, are you clean? Is your home clean for God? Are you putting your hands into sin or things you are not supposed to do? Do you have things in your house that are idols? Things in your house that God's eyes cannot behold? Things in your house that, you know, children of God should not have? Those are things that can make God to cut his visit to a person's home short. My Father in the Lord, that's according to our general overseer, Pat Josiah Akindayomi, once preached a message about this. He said we must keep our houses clean if we want God there. God detests dirt so much that if he finds any unclean thing in a camp, he leaves. That's according to Deuteronomy 23:14. He asked, When last did you clean under your bed? If it is full of dust and dirt, God cannot stay. Those who work with me know that if you claimed to have cleaned the room and I find dust at the top of the door, You may have to repeat the cleaning because I want anywhere I am to be conducive for God to stay. You know, there's a popular saying that cleanliness is next to godliness. God is the only God. Even though he's a spiritual being, even in the physical, God does not tolerate dirtiness. So apart from the fact that even your own life, your spiritual life must be holy, you must be holy, you know, spiritually and things of God, you must also be holy physically, even in your home. If you want God to come into your home, your physical home, your physical address, your house must be clean. Your house must be neat, must be in order. And this is especially going out to people who just do things anyhow, leave things anyhow. And you know, you have dust and cobwebs all around the house and they don't care. You want God to come into your home, that place must be clean. Because he told the Israelites that nothing unclean must be found in the camp. So they had to clean up, they had to take care of their environment because God was coming. And our father-in-law is saying that his father in the Lord, the founder of the Redeemed Christian Church of God, used to preach it too, that in your home, if under your bed is dirty, God cannot stay there because it is dirty. If there are corners in your house that are dirty, because the presence of God will fill the house, and God cannot stay anywhere that there is there. He cannot stay there. He will not stay there. So we need also, if we are going to cultivate the presence of God, we want God to dwell in our homes, we need to also be clean in our own homes too. Because God will only dwell in a clean environment. Paraki Dayomi also taught us that God cannot stay where ungodly music is played. This is because music carries a spirit with it. If you play godly music, the spirit of God will stay. But if you play worldly music, demons are invited to stay. What kind of music do you play in your home? This can determine if God will stay in your home or not. So we're also being told here that the kind of music you play in your home also matters. Because we know that music can touch you at different levels, even at emotional and spiritual levels. So if you are playing godly music, of course, God will be present. But if you are playing worldly music, then the spirits of the world will be present in the home. So that's another determinant of whether God is going to stay in your house or not. Finally, God is love. He cannot stay where strife and bitterness persist. If you are always fighting and insulting your spouse, you are sending God away. Instead, pray together. Raise an altar of praise in your home. Once there is an altar where you and your family meet to pray and praise God, you can be sure he will dwell with you for as long as you want him to. Jesus loves you. He wants to stay in your home. Make it conducive for him today. So, God is love. And God only dwell anywhere there is love. If there is strife, if there is bitterness, always fighting, God will not be there. If God has been there, he will leave. So for you to ensure that God abides with you, ensure that there is love, the atmosphere in your home is an atmosphere of love, is an atmosphere of peace. Raise an altar together, pray, worship together, and study the word of God together. And Jesus will abide constantly with you. So make sure your home is conducive for Jesus. It is clean, it's a house of love, and you know, the atmosphere is one that is inviting to the Holy Spirit. And I pray God will help us in Jesus' name. So our prayer point is, using the lessons learned today, make sure everything is in place for your home to be conducive for God to stay when he comes. So make sure your house is always clean. Make sure your house, the atmosphere in your house is that of worship. And make sure that there is always love in your home. And I pray that as we keep to all these instructions, God will dwell permanently with us in Jesus' name. Let's say a word of prayer. Heavenly Father, I want to say thank you for your word. Thank you for your understanding of your word. Lord, we ask that you help us to constantly be clean, to be holy, both in within and without, to keep our homes clean, to keep the atmosphere as an atmosphere of worship, to constantly praise you, to constantly worship you. And also, Lord, that in our homes, there will be love, there will be peace, there will be joy in the mighty name of Jesus. And as we do all these things, dwell with us abundantly and permanently in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Heavenly Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen. Thank you very much. I look forward to seeing you again tomorrow. God bless you.